Hello, welcome to Dust to the End. This is a very interesting game because it does a lot of things right, and besides, it's very cheap. It's about 7.4 euros, so that's, yeah, it's one of the cheapest games you can buy on Steam. I mean, it's not even on sale. The problem with games like this is that developers have great ideas, great work ethic. They release the game, but sadly, it needs a little bit of, you know, an extended gameplay or more features. But to be honest, what they have right now is very good. You're basically a trader in the post-apocalyptic world. When you're going from place to place, you need water and food to survive during the journeys. You're going to basically do a little bit of buying over here and a little bit of selling over there. Of course, you have combat, turn-based combat, which is actually pretty good, considering what you have. And you also have crafting, and you also have the possibility of upgrading some cities to have better production, so you can trade a lot more things, and I don't know, it's just a lot of features that are really nice. Now, don't get, you know, distracted by this. This is easy, this is normal, this is like kind of medium or normal, and this is like hard. By the way, the enemies are very, very hard, so let's play the game right now. As you can see, we have a melee character and a ranged character, so let's go for the ranged one. We can pick two of the traits over here and one of the logistic trait over here. Let's go for more hit chance. And yeah, let's increase attack speed and caravan speed, of course. Of course, the other one's a little better. Water and food consumption by 15%. You know, it doesn't really matter. This is like, in a way, it's like Mountain Blade. After a while, the only thing that matters is speed. Oh, one thing I like about this game, look at this. And that's my head. Let's go for something matching. Yeah, we are like the road warrior right now. We're basically... Yeah, the road warrior. Well, except we have a hood instead of, you know, hair. Now, let's see over here. I guess this will be okay, so let's start. The game is an interesting system. The more you play in the combat, the more action points you gain. So you use this for 0 action points, and then you, when you get action points, you can use your abilities. So, in a way, it's interesting. Oh, well, let's enter my name. Now it's more interesting because the more time you take with the combat, the more deadly it becomes, in a way. So deadly for you and also for the other people. Also, let's watch these beautiful cutscenes. I mean, they're not really cutscenes, but you get the idea. One thing I don't like about the game is that they're telling us the story of Fallout again. And, you know, Fallout was told 20 years ago and still being told today. I just wish they had more inspiration when they're doing the stories. Maybe it's like the story of Fallout 2. Or not Fallout 2. What was that game called? It doesn't really matter. There are a lot of games that have this particular subject, and of course, they get invaded. By the Plague Doctors. Yeah, the graphics are nice, and don't worry, the game will look decent enough. One thing I didn't like about the game in early access is that it was not really full of content. Even now it doesn't have a lot of content, but because of the full gameplay loop being available to us, you can actually play it a long time. And yeah, the more you play, the more you like it, because the more you see a lot, you will see great things happening. Also, I really like the feeling of the game. Games usually lack immersion, but this one doesn't lack it. It's very nice. We escaped. And then you go into the desert and you get rescued by someone, and then someone says, "Hey, you are a trader from now on." Okay, okay. What is an undergrounder? Okay, let's just skip this part because, again, it's not really something interesting. You just have to choose between a companion. We'll go with Reed. And he gives you some money and, you know, you're going to do a lot of trading. Now, I didn't play a lot of the game, so I cannot tell you how the end game is, but here you just move from these villages around. And by the way, this is a very long trip, you need a lot of food and water. It'll also say how much food and water you need. Also have the inventory over here. As you can see, the items are very nice. I mean, it does look a bit like a mobile game, but to be honest, it's very clear, it's very... It will say what you are doing, and it also has a little description. Edible salt, HP... It's not very clean. Ban. Our quest is to buy items from here and go creating wealth. That'll give us experience and also the Jack's trolley. It looks like nobody wants it. Also, this is our current caravan, which is one of the very good things about the game. Actually have the melee unit in front. Combatant, non-combatant. And this is our gear. As you can see, he's wearing a leather helmet. And leather armor. As you can see, decreases his hit chance and he has a mace, which is... Well, it looks like it was, you know, chewed up by an ogre. Elf. And armor. Mood. Elfie, congratulations, everything is fine. So, yeah, if you take damage, you have to wait until they heal. It will actually be a little more interesting. Hammer specialization. Okay, you have the hammer. Level 1. Calm. Charismatic. Caravan. Okay, so that's us. You can see a lot of information. This is morale. Effect on HP plus 30 per round. My food is averaged. And now that we've got over, you know, the basic stuff. Wait. Let's see what we have. We have an old armor, which is basically trash. And also our weapons have ammo as well, so yeah. Range Bible part 1, lack of materials. Again, it's a game more about upgrades. You can upgrade your armors, you can upgrade your weapons, you can do a lot of crazy stuff in the game. You just have to know what to do it and how to do it. So let's go to our first mission. It will say what you need. It will say what you have available. And then you can move over there. As you can see, this is exactly like Mountain Blade, except it's post-apocalyptic one. And the graphics, even though they look like mobile graphic ones, they're actually super nice. Also, what? We have been playing for 8 minutes and not playing... Dune Bandits, you are mine. Autofight escape. Usually autofight means, well, you lose a lot of HP. Yes, yes. Hey, I didn't want to do that. Okay, this is his HP, as you can see it's 200 and 300, so 200 for the ranged one and 300 for the melee one. So melee is weaker than, you know, range, so depends to you, it really depends what you want to do. Attack the strong tank or then just the DPS. DPS can only be attacked by the ranged character, so yeah, range versus range or just you two against the tank. Ouch. Well, I guess I should have destroyed him first. Or you can just wait until you have enough to go for the special abilities. Oh, you missed your attack. Well, that's bad. Haha, he got his skill check. And I didn't get mine. That's very cruel. Damage is shown over here. Oh, he missed us both. Yeah, let's stun him. Okay, he's spreading the damage around, which is great. Oh, he's immune to the stun lock. Well, and because we use that that thing right now, we have 0 action points, so we have to shoot with a normal attack or use the normal attack. I love this one. I think I'll play more of the game because it's very interesting. Also, a caravan. What does a caravan do? Well, trade or attack, but I don't recommend you attack them. Okay, light laser, that, and a lot of other cool stuff. So you don't really want to attack them. Also, I don't think the pendants gave us anything. And as you can see, if you use your supply, your weight will go down. Also, you saw those crates over there, yeah, that's actually loot. The more you play, you also gain reputation. You can also access some very interesting things like life processing, so you can unlock more materials, you can unlock better materials, you can upgrade, you can, I don't know, make investments. The game is very detailed and very nicely made, so combat and the trading actually goes very well together. Sell price 110, so as you can see, we made a lot of money over here, so we have to, first of all, buy more supplies. And I guess this counts as food. Yuck. Now, you generally need twice the amount of water for the amount of food per travel. So that means if you need 10 food for a travel, you need 20 water. So 10 food, 20 water, 50 food, 100 water, and so on. Rat meat, well. Okay, we are regretting not having enough cactus. Yeah, rat burgers are the best burgers in the world. Demolition Man proved it a long time ago. As you can see, water and food are also very, very cheap. I don't know why it shows you like this. I mean, I think we spend all of our money on this one. Also, let me check my HP. I'm not sure how healing works because I didn't play a lot of hours before. You know, when you have a game like this, I just want to enjoy it. I only played about 1 hour before release, recording the video. Copper ore, antique trader. Okay, we actually managed to kind of elude the beasts. Now, the beasts will give you a lot of food, so it's actually a good idea to attack them. But because of the bandits, I had to attack them separately. Otherwise, this will not be a very fun campaign. Come on, use it. No, I'm very unlucky with that trigger. Now I have to start working on him as well. Armor break, that's kind of nasty. 97, so as you can see, 100% damage. I have a 10% chance to miss, and if we don't miss, we'll kill him. Nice. Also, stun doesn't do any damage, which is not ideal, but what can you do? Also, he's stunned, so that will deal additional damage. So that will be about... Oh no! He's immune to stun. That could have been a great amount of damage. But nope, we had to miss. Oh, he missed as well. Okay, now it's better. Coins and experience. As you saw, we get a lot of experience. Oh, okay, we got the food we needed. Go for the beast. Go over here is food and water. Okay, this is actually very dangerous what I'm doing. That's a melee one. This is a ranged one. They're actually pretty beefy, usually they're not this strong. Again, armor regenerates before every combat. Oh. Oh, disgusting. These are actually very strong bugs. Usually they were a little weaker. Okay, every miss is an opportunity. Oh, we got the critical and also the second shot. That's perfect. This could have been a very bad round. Well, I'm missing like crazy, to be honest. Okay, he's stunned. Now we'll get enough action points to actually use the knowing. Wait, that didn't do extra damage, did it? Whatever. Okay, a pretty tough battle, but if you fight them, you'll actually get materials. Baby bug beast and also bug beast meat. As you can see, it will roll your morale, but again, it's food, it's protein. If it doesn't work, just eat it as protein. You can also sell it to some other village, you can also get pickle. And we will be out of water soon. Also, our HP is dropping, which is very bad. Fucker village. Yeah, so that's your reputation, and it also, when it just found it can, okay. We have some water, I need a lot of water. How is the price for water? Well, I think it's a little more expensive than usual. Do I need the cotton or anything else? Also, do you want the copper worth 30 points? I don't know, it's a lot of thinking about. Okay, we're back. Oh, we already used all the water. Well, that's fast. So here we'll sell the soap. As you can see, we paid 165, so that's almost double the price we paid. Now, this is where things get a little tricky. The next destination will require us to have lime. But here is the catch. We can recruit someone new over here, we have the money. But the best ones actually are very expensive. We could also get a base later, I'm not sure. It says we can put them in a base. Believes that Venus can solve our problems. Safety needs supply free. Interesting, I'm not sure how that works. Maybe we'll get a few of them. Hey, look at these guys over there. Oh, actually I have 5 of these. Well, sadly we have to use all of them right now. And if you're not sure how the upgrading works, well, let me show you that. I'm not able to obtain, or whatever. No vehicles, no nothing. Where was the thing to upgrade your stuff? Morale is a little bit lower. Oh, from the inventory, okay. So as you can see, we can craft some items. For example, if we have cotton, we can make cloth. We can also upgrade our weapons and armor if we just have the right things. For example, for the wooden crossbow, we need 4 tentacles and 2 level 1 teeth. So we can upgrade their effect, which is great. For example, crit rate. So probably at the end of the game, you'll end up with things so good that you'll actually be able to destroy everything. But for now, we're actually super weak and super... how should I put it? We're basically like the victims of the desert. Target an obelisk and sword to gain more space. That's interesting. Stone. Okay, let's see what the quest are. I mean, creating wealth. Well, we almost have enough money to go and finish the quest. Let me see if I can sell all of this. $200 more. Eh. Close, but not close enough. I really want to do this right now. The problem is that the next location for the caravan is over here, so that's basically triple the distance between Trucker Village and Baisha Village. Shift. Oil and inferior soap. And for the trip we need water 16 and food 10. I guess we can try to go back, because the last time I tried to go on that very big journey we just got killed. Yeah, no, that's not good for our morale, to be honest. So let's have 10 of that and let's make the deal and get out of here. Also, some people complain that the game is pretty repetitive. No. And the... Well, like this village, the game is really a bit repetitive, but again, it mostly depends on how you like to play the games. Let's go back there. Sadly, Reed got fever. Why? Well, let's see what the caravan has. Economic crop, square repeat. Pork, that's actually something that looks edible. Paper and ancient books. To be honest, they are actually pretty expensive. I don't know what to do with them. I would like to attack that Doom Rubber, but we are a bit away. Okay, so probably the most efficient way to do it is look at over here, 16 and 8. Let's get a bit of extra water and then just buy out all of the soap again. As you can see, we have 400 soap over there, so the only problem is that this is very inefficient. Once you get vehicles and can have a bigger capacity, you can basically transport a lot more items across a bigger distance, and that will actually be a little better for you. But for now, we're kind of stuck playing like this. Which is not really a problem, but you'll... Oh. By the way, they fight among each other as well. I'm not sure how that works either. It looks like he healed. I shouldn't have used that item. But again, it was just for safety. The game didn't tell you this, but I think it's a lot better to just do this trade route for a long time. I think we have enough money to go back like a winner. Winner, chicken dinner. By the way, I think it will also get worse over time, so if you don't buy enough supplies, you might find yourself in trouble, because eventually the supplies from one village will run out and then you have to change the road, and yeah, that could be very bad. Okay, they have recovered, that's nice. And I also have a lot of money. Well, a lot of money, a bit of money. They're actually far away from me, so it's not really worth it to go after them if you're low. Low on items. No, not the way. More army. I guess rat meat is better than bug meat. Like I said. Burgers for the win! Actually, I'm not sure how much you can get for the oil in Okay, let's just leave. Actually, let's buy oil, all of the oil we can carry. 73, and take it back to the first village, which is the Cactus Village, which has a very nice name on it. Okay, look at them, just the border guard is just avoiding the Dune bandits. Okay, that was not so bad. No, just hit them until you get better. By the way, armor takes 50% of the damage you deal, so that's why you are actually... So yeah, armor is actually a lot stronger than you might think. So if he has, let's say, 32 armor, that's 60 points of damage. Okay, go for the stun. And now let's see if this... does more damage to the stun. Oh, come on, why do you miss so... Oh, wow, that's so annoying. Armor break, so now we'll deal more damage to him. No, let's do it like this. Now can we see the full effect? Six water, I guess that's not so bad. Overloaded. Well, I guess we do have a lot of water and food. I like how the weight is constantly dropping. Now, did we make a good deal? I guess if you take it from one place to the other, you'll always make a decent deal. Okay, let's finish this quest, Old Jack's house. What do you need? This we've got the cash, now what do we do with the cash? Some funds. An anti-bug beast drug. Good for the bug beast. I already have 4000 gold instead of, just a tiny bit short, okay. Oh, he has a box full of money. And plus your 4. His own clinking bag. Take these funds to border town and give it to Mayor Sorsby. We're going to cut them back. We don't have funds for transportation anymore. But yeah, that's right. We have to pay for transportation, so I guess it's fair. The trolley, it belongs to you. The trolley? He's spawning off all junk on use to play at being okay. Bug beast. A remnant of the old war, maybe. Alien, yeah. Quest completed, taxation or... Well, I guess we have a vehicle right now. Max weight is 72 instead of 52. Which is awesome. Now, what did we get? The taxation of what village? Banker information finished. This will gain reputation and also the drug, so... Oh, the tax. Okay, we have the tax. Dune civilian. Nice. So we have other factions as well. Property, no property, industry. I just love it when this game... When a game comes around. Wait. Okay, let's finish the... Wait a minute, I guess we can go to border town a lot easier from this side. Yeah, I guess we have enough food and water. I hope we can buy some there as well. So that's 46 over here. Okay, we're traveling with the border guard and some other stuff. Great, so let's see, they have rifle bullets. Oh, this is how we get ammo. Interesting. Okay, I heard you. You also have a big ship over here, stores be what you need. Box, okay. Okay, that's a lot of dialogue, to be honest. This is the hyena gang. Oh, we have a tavern over here. I guess you have more stuff over here. Black market. So this guy is a hammer specialist. MC hammer specialist. Extractor. Textile works. Binding tool? Whoa, that's actually super expensive. Well, looks like the healing stuff is not so expensive after all. But to be honest, I think I really want to invest in some proper armor. Oh, wait. Start the backpack. Larger carrying capacity, but it's limited. Load 5 plus 5. Actually, that's interesting. It's also a bit expensive for my taste right now. Wait, why is the crossbow so good? Wait, I have to look at it. Not inventory, caravan. I level up? Who leveled up? Oh, 84 and 71. Attack speed 12. Well, I guess the ammo is cheaper for it, so that's why it's better. I think. Attack speed is 6. Okay, looks like the world weapons are not so great, if you think about it. Damage is 92. Well, I guess it does more damage, but it has lower speed and the weight is 5. Oh, I guess we have to take into consideration the weapons themselves. 57, 62. Also, I think melee weapons have a much higher chance to hit than ranged ones, of course. I guess this would be the best improvement out of all of these. Also, I think they have their own stats. See, they have their own stats and some of the skills as well, so I guess it's super important to upgrade early. Immunity. Oh, this is actually pretty interesting. Okay, maybe I'll do another episode, I'm not sure. So let's see, that's the black market. Let's look at the shop. Oh, rabbit meat. Finally some meat, some food that increases your morale. Cigarettes, copper wire, simple biohazard suit. 10,000, time left 28 days. Well, I guess we're really in the big leagues right now. Message, what message? Oh, we have to spend cigarettes. Oh, that's nice, so that's actually a currency type. Oh, so that's what you hear in the tavern. Zombie man. Mercenary, higher cost day, monthly salary, okay. stupid, humble. Recreation. And we don't have a single, that's okay, that was actually pretty fun. A wheel battle. A wheel battle, really? Oh, this is where we can repair our stuff. So I guess this is the weakest out of all of them. 60,000 for a trial. I guess even the wheelbarrows are very expensive in the post-apocalypse. Five Dune Bandits. No, I'm very busy. Yeah. Super interesting. I also like the squatting Slav guy over here. Anyway, the game is good. I think I'll play another episode if I have enough time. Let's just save the game over here. And see you next time. Bye.